Welcome to Expo Today Live. We have Gary Katz here, President and CEO of International Securities Exchange. Thanks for being here.
Miranda, it's great to be here. Thank you.
Thanks. Well, big story for you. ISE Gemini has been doing pretty well. Has it been measuring up to what you've been expecting?
It's been exceeding our expectations. We launched on August 5th, so we're really in our third month of the exchange, and we're averaging about 3.5% market share, and that is now ahead of four other options exchanges in the U.S. As you know, this is our second exchange, the number 12 exchange in the industry, so to have so quickly made it into the fifth spot, we're really very pleased with that. There's still a lot of work to do, but for the start of a brand new business to have achieved that growth, which is record growth for this industry, even faster than ISE originally back in the year 2000. So we're very, very happy with it.
Wow. So what is in the pipeline in the future? Any big announcements for this year that you can share with us?
Well, we want to finish adding the names to ISE Gemini. So today we have about 699 products trading. There are over 2,000 options trading in the industry, so we want to add that. There are a number of market makers that are still going to be joining the exchange, so we're hopeful that we'll be able to add those liquidity providers into our market, and that will enhance the overall experience. As you know, today, options exchanges are competing not just in new functionality and new products, but on a pricing scale, and so that's something that we're continuing to fine-tune as well.
Right. And that's, I guess I wanted to come back to that, just sort of a 40,000 foot view. We have now 12 options exchanges.
I think of it as two and the other 10, so.
Of course. What are the biggest challenges that face the industry right now?
Fragmentation. I think that's an issue that's occurring in the equities markets. It's happening in the options markets as well. It looks like there are a lot of options exchanges, but if you think about what's taking place in the equities world, where you have a number of exchanges but many more dark pools, this is moving in that direction. It's just being done with exchanges because there are no dark pools in the options industry in the U.S. So we're having the same challenges that other marketplaces are having, and that is you get to interact with a smaller segment of the market. It is more difficult to create a robust price discovery mechanism as order flow and liquidity is fragmented across multiple exchanges. And it's a challenge for the market makers as well. They have to provide liquidity across 12 different exchanges, which means greater costs to them, and also they have to focus on controlling the risk across all of those markets so that they're not hit simultaneously in 12 different locations. And that's a challenge for them.
And that sort of brings me to another question, and that is how do you measure market quality? How does a customer measure that sort of thing when you have 12 different places oftentimes to trade the exact same thing?
Well, the term that's being used today is EQ, which is execution quality. Typically, it's measured by how much price improvement on average do you have relative to the national best bid and offer. And that's how a customer would look at it. An exchange like us, we would look at it from how tight are the markets on average, what's the size of our markets on average, and do the market makers step up in the auctions that we have to provide liquidity. And of course, you then go out and talk to your customers and you ask the simple question, how am I doing?
Speaking of customers, there's been a lot of demand from Europe in U.S. options markets.
Yep.
What's going on with that?
Well, the companies that are listed here are story stocks and very interesting to the markets globally. A company like Apple doesn't just have a following in the U.S., it has a following everywhere. It's not in every stock that's trading in the U.S., but there are some stocks like Apple, like a Twitter, like Facebook, that are global companies, and they attract a great deal of interest.
Well, listen, thanks so much for being with us today.
Oh, it's a pleasure always.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Stay tuned for more at Expo Today Live.